Hello everybody, it is Magma and I am back with another LEGO Star Wars 2014 Winterline pre-review slash analysis video. This time we have the set 75080, it is the AAT, 251 pieces, ages 7 to 12, and this is so far the most, the set where people are really unsure, mixed feelings. People don't know what to say about this set because they just don't know whether the set is good or it's not good. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and analyze the set. So we're going to go ahead and move on to the other picture. Alright, so here on this picture, we're going to go ahead and start off with the AAT. It looks, for me actually, it looks pretty good. If you compare it to the previous... I think it was 2001 or 1999 version. If you compare it to that version, they're almost the same size. This one is slightly smaller than the first one. So yeah. So honestly, I mean, I know it's small, but it's a $25 set, so it's like it's $25 less than what the other one was. However, I think we would all have loved to pay $25 more to get an actual sized one. So in this one, I think that you can put the droid on the top part, otherwise the rest is kind of I mean, honestly, it's really small. However, I don't think it's gonna be that bad. I think the LEGO will have found a way to add a bunch of features. For me, the only thing that's annoying on this set so far is that for me it looks like there is no playability in the inside, which is what I loved about, because I have one in Hasbro, in those other sort of toys when I was young, and I remember that it was the exact same one as this one, and you could play inside of it, and that was really fun. So I hope LEGO has found a way to add that as a playability. Otherwise, it looks okay. I think it's just slightly smaller, otherwise nothing else. The color is good. The tank, honestly, I'm just gonna definitely buy this set to get one of these. And honestly, I think all we have to do is just wait, and once I'll review it or once somebody else will review it, we're gonna be able to have a look at it. I'll definitely be reviewing this set as soon as it comes out. I'll try my best to get it, and we'll review this. Alright, as for the figures, well, actually, no. We're gonna go ahead and sound a tank right now for a second. As you guys can tell, this set has a new color of the missiles. The missiles are orange on this set, which is something we did not have yet on the other sets. So this one is orange, which is extremely movie accurate. So the set looks very movie accurate, however small, and I don't feel too many features as of the inside and playability. For the figures, we get one battle droid, one pilot droid. That's really bad figures, however, they are good army builders. So if you guys want to buy multiple of this set, battle droid, you can have many. And the pilot droid, you're going to need that figure to put it in this set. Next, we have Jar Jar Binks. So Jar Jar Binks come with the correct equipment, which is a shield and one of those... launching spears, whatever they are. So the good thing is that since he has weapons, you can use him as a Gungan soldier. On the other side, I mean, it's Jar Jar Binks, but the good thing is that since he has weapons, I'm just gonna, if I buy multiples of this set, I'm just gonna add him and say that he's a Gungan soldier, because yeah. Alright, that's about it for this preview. Thank you guys for watching. I think this set won't be bad as you guys think. I'm actually pretty excited for it. I will definitely review this set for you guys, and I will see you guys in another pre-review. Thank you guys, and bye-bye.
We'll be right back.